Hello dear Vister. My name is Jurt. I am a retired Dutchman. Because I like to deal with everything that has to do with movies, I have set up a YouTube channel called Film Noir. It's my pleasure to give you as much viewing pleasure as possible. Therefore, my intention is to add on a regular basis the most appreciated 20th century movies to my channel. Today's movies is The Return of White Fang. The Return of White Fang is a 1974 adventure western film directed by Lucio Fulci. Lucio Fulci, born on June 17, 1927, died March 13, 1996, was an Italian film director, political activist, screenwriter, and actor. He is known for his extremely bloody and gory film, and is seen as the bloodiest filmmaker ever. Generally, he is regarded as a gifted craftsman with a sharp tongue and a distinctive sense of dark humor who remains as controversial in death as in life. Starring in this film, Franco Nero, born November 23, 1941, San Prospero Parmense, Emilia-Romagna, Italy. Franco Nero is an Italian actor, producer, and director. He has appeared in more than 200 movies around the world, working with Europe's top directors such as Luis Buñuel, Rainer Werner Fassbinder, Claude Chabrol, Sergei Bondarchuk. In this movie, he plays Jason Scott, a novelist who's on a book tour down south and agrees to come to assist Sister Evangelina. Co-starring is Virna Lisi. Virna Lisi, born as Virna Pyrolisi, November 8, 1936, died December 18, 2014, was an Italian actress. This stunning Italian actress began her film career as a 17-year-old teen in 1953. Her final film, Latin Lover, was shot in 2014 and released in 2015. During production, she was already very ill from cancer and died shortly after. The film is dedicated to her in the end credit. In this film, she plays Sister Evangelina, who runs a new mission hut in the town to convert into a hospital. She decides to ask Mr. Forth for funding to operate her hospital. Also co-starring is John Steiner. John Steiner, born January 7, 1941 in Chester, Cheshire, is an English actor. John is tall, blonde and thin. He portrayed some of the most memorable villains of Italian cinema during the 1970s and 1980s. In this film, he plays Beauty Smith, who lives under the alias Charles Forth, a local businessman, and fakes a crippling injury by confining himself to a wheelchair with his two henchmen always at his side. You will do me a great favor by hitting the like and subscribe button on my channel. Thank you very much for that. See you at the next movie. Here comes The Return of White Fang. Enjoy.
Don't be sad, Mixa. We can't take you along with us. The trip is too hard.
Mitza is afraid to be here alone. Right, Mitza?
I'm not afraid. And I won't be alone. I have a friend. Right, White Fang?
Let's go.
We don't care, do we, White Fang? You wanna play? Come on. Jump. Come on. Jump, White Fang. Jump. Come on. Get it. Come on.
We're in luck. Those Indians are going to save our skins. How much, Indian, for that canoe? Maybe you didn't hear right, Indian. I was intending to buy you a canoe. What are you asking for it?
Sorry, but we have to use it. Transport furs.
We'll buy all the damn furs, too. That suits you?
They are already promised.
What do you mean, Indian? Don't talk nonsense.
That's enough, Ted. If they don't want to sell it, let them keep it.
White Fang, hurry!
Advice. Take it easy now. There's a good fella. Ain't nobody gonna hurt you, fella. You just take it easy now. Easy. I ain't gonna hurt you, so don't you worry. Who are you guarding there, huh? Your master. We don't want him to get bit up by the wolves, now, do we? I ain't afraid. I know you're just doing your job. Well, now I gotta help you, understand? You stay in the cold, you're free. That wouldn't be any good. You know I'm your friend, don't you? Sure you do. Because you're a clever dog. That's a good fella. He's a great spirit. Watch out for your son. This way, at least. You're safe from the wolves, boy.
Hold still, darling. Now look straight ahead.
Everybody ready? Hold still. Don't move.
Very, very
Thank
good.
You. Gentlemen, ladies, shall we go into the next room?
There you are, miss.
Thank you. Mr. Scott, I understand you were studying to become a doctor before you began to travel and write. What happened to your love of medicine?
Let's say that my love for people was stronger.
Please excuse me, Mr. Scott. Now that I see you, I would like to do a photo story on you. I'm quite sure that our readers picture you as I did, a husky, bearded bear of a man, like the prospectors you write of in your books.
Well, if I were you, I wouldn't disillusion them completely. Off the record, madam, I chew tobacco, and I'm very rough with women.
Mr. Scott. Mr. Scott.
Yes?
I find your book upsetting. I think it quite mad.
Jason Scott.
Yes?
I want to speak to you alone.
Excuse me.
Come over here. Sit down there. Waiter?
Anything you say, mademoiselle.
I think you're a big liar, Jason Scott. White Fang doesn't exist.
What makes you so sure of him?
Well, now, if you had a dog like that one, you would have taken him with you. No one leaves a dog like White Fang behind.
You know something? You're right. I'll tell you what happened. It was actually White Fang who left me when he found out I was coming here. And just between us, this is no place for White Fang.
Yeah, that's for darn sure. Okay, you're not a liar.
Thank you.
Look here, Scott, I have to speak to you.
Guess there's nothing we can do.
Unfortunately.
Scott, you seem to forget. I spent a lot of money to launch your book, and what do? You waste your time with people who don't count.
Who don't count, huh? You're pretty foxy, you know. Your literary soirees give me a tremendous nostalgia for the Klondike. Those people out there may be crazy, but by God, they're real.
So you're going back to write some more stories, then?
You bet I am. And when I do, I'm going to give them to another publisher.
Excuse me, please.
Yes?
May I have your autograph, Mr. Scott?
Of course.
Let's go get some. wolf. Here, boy. Come on, huh? What's the matter? Don't you like Grey Wolf for a name? What do you want to be called? Firebrand. Hey, that's not a bad name, Firebrand. Hey, wait here, Firebrand. See this boy? Go get him, Firebrand. Firebrand's no good either, huh? Didn't like Grey Wolf. Well, what is your name? You sure you don't like Firebrand? I'm gonna call you stupid. Stupid dumb dog. How do you like stupid for a name, huh? Hey. Don't go thinking. I'm afraid because of your white fangs. What? You mean your name's White Fang? White Fang? Grandpa! 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 I found out the dog's name!
Yeah. Who told you?
He did. It's White Fang.
Oh, White Fang, huh?
See for yourself. White Fang! Here, White Fang!
Well, he ain't exactly jumping for joy.
You'll see, Grandpa. We're gonna be friends. White Fang, here!
So hey, it's look. White Fang, is it?
Is this $10 yours, Grandpa? Huh?
Well, I'll be darned. Listen. Don't you tell anybody, you understand? You know how people's minds work. You see, son, they think they can buy dogs and a sled for just $10 and then just head north. So don't you breathe a word, understand?
Come on, White Fang. Let's have some fun. Come on. Come on.
Broken no time.
He's crazy as always, old Tarwater. Can't blame his kids for not giving him any money. If he had a dog and a sleigh, he'd go looking for gold up north, as old as he is. Every 10 years, he goes haywire. It's gold crazy. And it's just 10 years since the last time he came back from the Klondike.
Let's say $100.
Darn. On the word of John Tarwater.
I don't bet on no word.
Oh, now hold on there, stranger. Everybody knows me in these parts. I got 9 sons, 23 grandchildren. God knows how many nieces and nephews. If I lose, they'll stand good for me.
All right, then. Would you mind signing what you just said? They mightn't be so willing to take care of your debts for you, understand? Please.
Grandpa! What are you doing, Grandpa?
Shh. I'm plucking a pigeon.
I raised to 300.
Don't play anymore, Grandpa. If you lose, they'll lock you up because you can't pay.
I'll see you. Can you beat 4 sevens?
White Fang!
He had an ace in the hole. The guy's a crook. Pay back that $100 you won yesterday, or I'll...
There to me is my little grandson, young Bill. He's gonna make a real Tarwater one of these days. Mark my words. Yeah. You're disappointed that we left him behind. I know. I know.
Afraid of having a tooth pulled off.
Oh, you, Bill, it was your tooth.
Did that hurt?
Yeah.
It's only a question of getting used to pain.
Oh, sure.
Open. Now, open.
I did it.
Instead of standing here, laughing like idiots, why don't you help me to build a decent hospital?
Take more than willing hands to turn this hut into a hospital, Sister Evangeline.
Why?
That's right, Sam. I've already told you, Sister. There's only one person who can give us all the material we need, and that's Mr. Forth.
Well, good.
Sister, Mr. Forth's got everything you need. But he won't lift a finger to help you. I'll take a bet on it.
Why would he refuse me?
We got 300 pounds. You can go.
Nexton?
Ah!
Thank you, Harvey. Say a prayer for me. I would like to speak with Mr. Forth, please.
Follow me.
What's the matter, sister? You look as if you've just seen a ghost.
No, not a ghost. But a devil.
Maybe we can pull it out backwards.
Go, darn tree. Hey, quit your yapping. I'll cut you loose. Don't pull hold!
Grandpa! Grandpa!
Stop!
Stop! White Fang! No, White Fang! Come back!
Stop! Stop!
Come back! Grandpa! White Fang's gone too!
At all. Good boy. Please, why don't you sit down? We have already met Mr. Forth, I believe.
Yes, many years ago in Dawson City. But his name wasn't Forth then. It was Beauty Smith. And everybody remembers him for what he did there.
Beauty Smith. It would be interesting to meet the man who bears such a striking resemblance to me.
I am not mistaken. I think the good Lord could not have made another face like yours.
And if I tell you I've never been in Dawson?
Then you lie.
It's your word against mine, sister.
No. It's not my word alone.
I guess you weren't expecting us, were you, Beauty?
Too bad you were paralyzed. Because if you weren't, I'd smash every bone in your body.
Gentlemen, that's enough.
I represent the law here. I think you'd better tell me who you are.
An inspector of mine, sir. And here's Jason Scott, the writer.
The writer? What are your charges against Mr. Forth.
Three years ago, it's easy to prove my innocence. Kill an old man, to hold a child, a hostage, to blow up a dam. It seems it would require more than the brutality and cynicism Mr. Scott so blithely attributes to me. I think it would require the use of one's legs.
There was nothing wrong with your legs in Dawson.
That's where you're wrong, I'm afraid. Lieutenant LeClaire, how long have we known each other?
We met 5 years ago in Alberta. He was already in a wheelchair at the time.
Are you quite sure you're not mistaken?
My memory, sir, is excellent.
Liars. You are a disgusting pair of liars.
Sister. You know I could have you arrested.
Go to the devil.
Please, sister. Calm down. Under the circumstances, there's nothing left for me to do but to offer my profound apologies to Mr. Forth, who we hoped was Beauty Smith.
I accept your apology.
Since no charges have been made, I'll be happy to forget the whole thing. Goodbye, sister. Goodbye, gentlemen.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Believe a word I said. Not that inspector, nor that writer Scott. As of today, Beauty will have to respect the law like everyone else. The whole thing's getting too dangerous.
If the game's worth anything, you're bound to run some risks.
Not me. I told you right from the start. An officer. I refuse to get involved in a scandal. Risk dishonor.
I married an imbecile. I was better off when I worked in Beauty's saloon.
Jane. Jane.
Jane. Jane. Jane is sick and tired of this stupid life. I want to live somewhere warm for a change. In a city. I want beautiful clothes. I want a beautiful house. I want money. And if you can't give them to me, it's finished between us, Charles.
I can't live without you. You know that.
Beauty is the only one who can make us rich. Don't you understand?
I'll do what you want.
We heard some barking and we went to have a look. Well, we found this dog pulling the sled like crazy. All by himself. I ain't kidding either. Take a look at the load he was pulling. In there. You'll never believe what was on that sled. Pile of junk like you've never seen before. There was an old man out of his mind, cold. And a little kid. And it's a miracle they were alive.
Now there's a man who has two good reasons for giving thanks to God.
I'd like to know at least one of those reasons.
You can know both. He has a beautiful young daughter. And 300 pounds of supplies.
You made two mistakes. First of all, she's not my daughter, she's my sister. And secondly, I don't have all those supplies.
But you're pulling out, aren't you?
Yeah. We're pulling out. But not for the high plains. We're heading back. I'm fed up of what's going on around here. I wish to hell I'd never set foot in this godforsaken spot in the first place.
Well, I'm sorry about that. I'm really sorry about that.
Sister or daughter? It doesn't really change anything, does it?
But the fact that you're going away, too, changes everything.
Why don't you tell me exactly what's going on here?
I guess you're the only one who doesn't know, huh?
Liverpool.
Yeah?
I'm going to return Jonathan's frying pan.
All right, so what is going on here?
When you buy supplies from Ford, you got to sign a contract with him. And if you find any gold, half of it belongs to him. He stays here nice and safe. And the one who takes all the risk practically works for him. And that's not all. He charges the earth for 300 pounds of supplies, and he only gives you 200 pounds.
But according to the law, 200 won't get you an exit pass.
The law here is completely under Forth's thumb. Once you sign a contract with Forth, the carrier give you your pass.
Since you've decided to leave anyway, you've got nothing to lose. I'll make you a deal. You sign the contract, and I'll buy you your 300 pounds of supplies.
But Forth will only give me 200.
Exactly. And Leclerc will sign your pass. And his signature will be the proof of his collaboration. Can you get back without their catching on?
I think so.
Good. We'll go to Norman together. There's a judge there. We'll press charges against Leclerc for his complicity with Forth.
Hey, White Fang! Fang!
Been all this time, huh? Good boy. How are you, sir?
Look, mister, that's my dog, not yours, huh?
I guess he belongs to the one he loves.
And you're saying he loves you as well.
And you're saying you're his master. Well, that's quite a problem. Do you have a solution?
What'd happen if we let White Fang choose? Okay, mister?
Fair enough. How do we do it?
Let's see who he follows. You walk away in that direction, and I'll go in the other. Okay?
Okay. My name is Jason Scott. Goodbye.
And I'm Bill Tarwater. Pleased to meet you.
Let's go.
If I share them with you?
Stop!
Let's see your permit.
I'll give you a word of advice. When you stop for the night, tie one of your dogs a little distance from the fire. When it gets too cold, he'll bark and wake you up, and it'll remind you to put wood on the fire. The cold's a killer. You remember, mister, keep up a good fire. If you don't, you've had it. You can go. Good luck.
Thanks. Wah! Ah! I don't have any excuses. I meant to deceive you, and that's all there is to it. I did a rotten thing, and I realized just how rotten it was when I saw those two men out there in the snow. I wanted to go looking for gold, but they made me think about all those men who died because they were shortchanged by Ford. It's easy enough to head out, but it's next to impossible to survive without sufficient rations. Poor Jimmy. Jimmy was already dead. I left him out there in the snow and ice. And Carter, well, he doesn't stand much of a chance either, I guess.
Mr. Scott.
Hey, Harvey. What is it?
You've got to come to the mission, Mr. Scott. Sister Evangeline needs you.
I'll be right with you.
Take it easy, Carter. You're gonna be all right.
Sister Evangeline, she'll take care of you. Don't you worry none. You'll see. You're gonna be all right.
I can't.
I'm not a surgeon.
I know, but we have nobody else. Can't you see he'll die if we don't operate?
Don't you worry, Nigel. You're in good hands. Here, Connor. Take a sip of this.
I know a little. I can help you. Please.
What you're asking is impossible. It would be useless to try.
But the gangrene will kill him. We must do something. Otherwise, it would be criminal.
I can't stand the pain.
His legs are like two rotten branches. They gotta be cut off, or he's a goner for sure. I'd do it myself, but my hands ain't so steady anymore. Kurt, take Bill away.
Give him some whiskey.
Yeah. Look here, Carter, you're gonna get yourself some free whiskey. Make you feel better. More, huh? More. Nice boy. Feel better already, don't you? Feel better already.
I won't do it to me.
want to know who it was? I'll tell you. It was a goddamn wolf the Tarwater brat drags around. That's who it was.
What? White Fang did it?
I saw it. Leave me, you dog's a killer. What are you waiting for? The kid gets him at the mission. Let's kill the brute.
Get away. They're gonna kill you. No. Run for your life. Run for your life. Go on. They'll kill you if you don't. They'll kill you if you don't. Go on. Run. Go on.
Secret, Carter. I ain't figuring on dying till I find my gold mine. Because I am getting kind of old, the day I find that mine is getting closer all the time. Trust me, Carter. We'll divide the gold. Half and half. Just like you were gonna do with your pal, Jimmy.
White Fang! White Fang! White Fang!
Give me a damp cloth. Good boy. This may hurt a little.
I think you'd better go around telling anyone that White Fang's back. We'll keep him hidden here. Come on. Just for the time being. Safer.
Carter had a map of the mine. He's sure to have given it to Tarwater. You can bet on it. That's why the old man's taken off.
Tell me, my friends, if you had a map of a gold mine, what's the first thing you'd do?
Well, I would hide it.
so nobody would steal it from me, for sure.
A smart man would memorize it first. For once in there, it would be harder for anyone to take it away from him. If Carter is less of an idiot than you are, that's what he'd have done. That is, if the mind is not just a figment of his imagination. Good work, Harvey. You won't be sorry you're on my side. Beauty no longer has any need of Mr. Forth.
But you were...
It was a useful alibi, in case anyone recognized me. And now, gentlemen, the time's come to act.
I can't breathe. I can't breathe.
I sent for the sister. I don't know what to tell. She must be. She'll be here soon.
Yes, here she is now.
Everyone. I've been with White Fang all day. Where's my grandpa?
Please, get me something to drink. Whiskey. I feel terrible.
But I can't. You're not
Please,
supposed to.
Please, just a drop.
I've come to ask a favor of you. Where's the mine Tower is heading for?
Hey, Beauty, look!
Leave him alone!
Stay where you are, kid.
Going off. It's a small group. Fir trees. Like a circle. On the high plains. Just after you cross the whole valley.
Sister, say you thought she might need your help.
Okay.
I don't care that goddamn dog.
What do you want?
Please, let us through.
Sorry.
Bill, tell the lieutenant what you saw last night.
Two men came to the mission. They tortured Carter. They wanted information from him. Then they started the fire. I heard the name of one of the men. It was Beauty.
Do you still think there are two men called Beauty, Lieutenant LeClaire? Or do you admit that Beauty and Forth are one and the same person? And that Forth was no more paralyzed 6 years ago in Alberta than he is today.
Mr. Scott.
Murder him! Hang him! They killed Sister Evangelina too! Murder him!
Mr. Scott, with your permission, I would like a few minutes alone.
Ill last night.
There wasn't any other way.
E tu non avresti permesso.
Non avrei dovuto permettere niente fin dal principio.
A te non bastava il tenente Leclerc. Dovevo lasciarti partire.
No. Oh no, Charles. I love you. I swear it. Everything I wanted for myself, I wanted for you too.
Sergeant, it's up to you to arrest Beauty now. Or Forth, if you prefer.
You won't catch him. He left last night.
Where did he go?
North. To the high plains where Carter's mine is. They're going to kill the old man, too.
Yeah!
down that way.
Ah! 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 Me! Ah! Hey! Yeah! Yeah!
Stay put, White Fang. Sergeant. I'll try to flush them out. Cover me.
Don't risk it, Scott. They can't hold out. Sooner or later, they'll have to surrender.
Beauty couldn't trick White Fang, but he sure tricked us. Come on.
Hurry up!
Thank you.
have of mine is for Carter, and the other half is for a little Bill. I found it. Or yes, I feel very happy. I never felt so.
It was his mine. Now it belongs to Bill.
You're wrong there, Mr. Scott. Tarwater died before he registered the claim. According to the law, the mine isn't his. The law says a mine belongs to the man who registers it with the Land Commission. It's not enough to find it. I propose a dog sled race from here to the commission office. The winner gets the mine.
Ready? Fire!
Down! 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 up, 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 up.
That current! We need to change the docks! Come on, come on! Move, move, move!
Hey, how come we're not waiting down there with the others? Change the dogs.
Because Scott's smarter than they are.
You see, they're all coming in together. Look! Changing dogs all in the same place is gonna waste a lot of time. Oh, Scott really was clever. You see? Ha! Harvey.
Hey! Is that smart or is Kurt?
Oh, I wouldn't say that. He's just as smart.
But he doesn't have White Fang. And he doesn't know that we have him. Nobody knows that you're back.
Yeah, I'm afraid Harvey has got too much of a lead. Even for White Fang.
Hey! Hey! Ho! Ha! 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 Ha!
Ha! Ha!
Ha!
Ha! Ha!
You shot White Fang!
Winner.
Commissioner's waiting for you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
My congratulations. Please.